they attacked by land. By air and by sea.
Squads of masked men in black, armed with assault rifles, inside of Israeli towns and cities.
This day is the Great Revolution Day to put an end to the last occupation and last apartheid regime in the world.
Capturing innocent hostages, creating terror on the streets of Israel.
And we've seen extraordinary videos of Israeli civilians being dragged away by militants, supposedly into the Gaza Strip.
Heavily armed militants going house to house.
Hamas taking Israel by complete surprise in what's being called an intelligence failure for the ages.
It's beyond any expectation of what Israel thought was possible. They had no information as far as we know.
The retaliation, quick and brutal.
We are at war. Not an operation, not rounds, but at war.
Israel vowing to decimate the Gaza Strip, which is the most densely populated city in the world, warning residents to evacuate immediately.
We will defeat them to death and take revenge for this black day they have inflicted on the state of Israel and its citizens.
Already hundreds have died on both sides of the conflict and thousands have been injured. Hospitals are completely overwhelmed.
The United States stands with the people of Israel in the face of these terrorist assaults.
Israel has a right to defend itself, which is what it is doing.
It's an unprecedented attack by Hamas, who says it's retaliation for years of Israeli atrocities, with Israel imposing a blockade on the heavily contested Gaza Strip since 2007, restricting movement and controlling goods into the tiny coastal city.
There's a clear Palestinian response to unprecedented level of Israeli settlers attacks and unprecedented level of killing Palestinians.
Now, with both sides vowing that this is just the beginning of all-out war, the destruction and misery is sadly just beginning.
Well, Mark Sofer is a former Israeli ambassador to Australia. He's in Tel Aviv. Mark, what's it been like on the ground over the last 24 hours?
Well, last night there were a series of sirens, air raid sirens, which went off, which sent everybody scuttling to the safe spaces, the shelters. But over the last night and this morning, there's a sort of an eerie silence. People not going out of their homes, watching glued to the television screens, and terribly worried about their loved ones, their family, their friends in the carnage in the south.
The pictures that are coming out of Israel at the moment are heartbreaking. We know this is a region that knows war and knows conflict. But why is this moment different?
This time is not a little skirmish. It's not another round. It's not just one more interaction between the Hamas and Israel. This is war. This is a game changer. And Israel, all Israelis, are united in understanding one thing and one thing alone, that what was will not be. In other words, there will be a total overhaul of the situation on the ground, and it remains to be seen how that will play out.
It now looks like there could be dozens of Israeli civilians held in Gaza. Does that complicate a ground invasion?
Of course, if there are hostages, it'll complicate matters. The feeling is, or the knowledge, I don't know about the knowledge, but the general atmosphere that the Hamas does is that they take hostages, or they will take the hostages into a safe space for them, which is perhaps underneath a hospital in the tunnel systems they've set up there or elsewhere. And naturally, this complicates matters greatly, and we'll have to deal with that.
As heinous as this attack is, the reality is this is a people in Gaza who have been locked off, occupied, with their lives controlled for years. Is it inevitable that at some point they react?
No. It's not inevitable. We have been always ready to assist the people of Gaza. We've allowed tens of thousands of workers to come across. We are supplying with electricity, food, water, everything. The people who rule Gaza, the Hamas, are basically our equivalent here of ISIS, and we cannot allow the border to be open and open ourselves for incessant attacks by this group of murderers, actually. And this is what we are facing. And we have, I think, like every country in the world, the right to defend ourselves, and we will continue to do so.
Of course, there are many civilians inside Gaza, and as you pointed out, what was will not be. I think that's the line that's coming out of many leaders in Israel. Your Prime Minister has said that the Gaza Strip may be turned into a deserted island. It's clear that there will be a very strong response to this. What is a proportionate response here?
Well, I don't know what a proportionate response is for the massacre of 350 people at least. At least, I say, because there are still hundreds languishing in hospitals, very many of them fatally wounded. But what is for certain is that we are have no interest in whatsoever in killing innocent people. There will be, I fear, collateral damage, but this won't be indiscriminate as we have faced now by the Hamas grouping of killers. Such a situation as we found ourselves in yesterday will not recur, must not recur, and everything that will be done in order to prevent it from recurring, whatever that takes.
Mark Sofer, thanks for your time.
Thank you.